Hey there guys, welcome to another video. My name is Sparckman, I'm a game developer. And today we are going to create another mobile game. Let me show you the demo. Now the graphics are terrible, just bear with me. And so you have to press spacebar. And if you don't land on the target, you lose. I set this game for iOS and I thought it was pretty easy to make, so I decided to make a clone. I think the game is called Rocket, I'm not sure. All right, so that target keeps moving and we have to hit it. I'm going to press spacebar to launch the... Oh no! Try it again. Yes, I got it. Level 2. He's moving faster now. Oh, I missed. And you can see that this game is very simple, very good for monetizing. Okay, so let's open our working file, which you can find under the description below. To open this example, you're going to need Fusion. If you don't have it, there is a link down below. Download the software. Alright, so let's double click on the spaceship, and you can see that we have 32 directions. These here are just static objects. This here too is a static object. Wow, these two here is a static object. Okay, so I think you get the point. They are all static objects. So I'm going to select the green object and let's turn this into a circular object. So let's run the frame and you can see that this moves in a circular pattern. So we're going to center this object. We know that this is 640 by 480. So the X is going to be 320 and the Y is going to be 240. Let's try it out. Whoa, that's in the middle now. Maybe we can increase the radius. Let's increase the radius to 200. Whoa, that's moving way too fast now. I'm going to change the angular velocity to maybe 40. Whoa, that's much better. Now, if you want this to run backwards, all you have to do is go minus 40. And now it moves clockwise. Okay, so let's go to the event editor. Let's create a new condition. If this counter is set to 0. Then we're going to make the spaceship look in direction of the green object. Try it out. Whoa. It now follows it. Let's make this object a bouncing ball. Moving at start new. Back to the editor. If I press spacebar, we can set this counter to 1. And let's start the spaceship. Press spacebar. Whoa! We can also change the speed of the object to 100. Whoa, that's fast. New condition, if our object is outside the play area, then we destroy it. If the spaceship collides with the green box, which is our target, then we destroy both. Try it out. Press spacebar. Whoa, that works. Now we can also affect the speed of the green object. Start of the frame. Simply change the speed of the green object. Let's try 100. Whoa, that's much faster. Let's make this object invisible. Whoa, we missed. So let's make our green object change positions. New condition. We're gonna use calculation. Random range. 100 milliseconds to 600. Then we're gonna swap positions with another object. Whoa, now it's changing positions randomly. We're gonna make these objects invisible. Whoa, now it's much harder. Oh no, I missed. I'm gonna make a new counter. Put this counter here. If this new counter is greater than 0, then we add 1 to it. If the counter is equals 50, then we restart the frame. And now we just need to add 1 to that counter when the collision happens and when he leaves the play area. That works fine. Yes, let me enter a score. Here's my score. Now this doesn't get reset if you restart the frame. Let's make this green, just because we can. Now if we hit the target, we're going to add 1 to the score. Add 1. And if we don't hit the target, we set it back to 0. Move this out of the way. And let's try it out. try to hit the target. No! Stop moving! Yes! I got one. I got 1 point. Can I hit that thing again? No! One. Two. Oh no, why would I do that? I knew he was gonna move. I just knew it. Alright, so I'm going to make a template for this game, so it will be available at the Spark Store. Alright, so thanks for watching. Follow me on Twitter, and I will see you in the next video. Bye now.